To see Story Cup 5, this is Nimsh, and I'm joined this time on this couch by Chinoys and Mitsu Hyde from Team Sector 1. So, guys, how are you doing? Like, you are here, this is the first Team Story Cup for you guys, right?
Yeah, true.
And how are you? Are you having fun? Are you hanging out with others? Watching games? Playing Hearthstone?
Yeah, we just came to hang out with you guys. Like, we heard this was the best event to, like, attend. It's really chill atmosphere, like a bar, poker, everything. It's so cool, and it's really cool to see the players in real life.
All right, Chinoys,
yeah,
how are you having fun?
For me, it was like 1 hour, 30 minutes to the car.
Oh, okay.
It was here, like, yeah, just insane, like poker. Yesterday we pokered with Forsen, and yeah, the bar, and of course the players.
Yeah, and you can also cast with us here on the couch, which is awesome. And Mitsu Hyde, you just qualified for WCA, I've heard. So you played a qualifier that nobody knew about, or did you play versus some people there?
Well, most people knew about it, but like the organizers didn't announce it, so there wasn't people who signed up didn't receive an email or something.
Okay.
I just had to look on the Russian website for the sign up button and the check-in button, and there were mostly just Russians.
But still, had to have a good score to actually qualify, right? How many people did you defeat?
Yeah, you had to like win a 128 man bracket, I think.
Oh yeah, that's a big one.
You had to get first.
All right, so congratulations. I hope you're fresh for the analysis for this match. The next match, this match that we're going to see is Eloise versus Naiman, which is the winner's match. So whoever wins that goes to tomorrow, which is the top eight. But before we talk about the lineups, let's talk about our promotional site. So there is something for you guys as well. If you go to Facebook page, which is TechTV Facebook page, you can click on the raffle and you can sign up here on the raffle to have a chance to win some amazing prizes like Sennheiser's, Game One Black, some peripherals from Logitech, Maxonomic, Need for Speed chair, and also like shirts and hoodies. Just fill it out and click enter to win. Then obviously shout out to our sponsors, Need for Speed, responsible for great chairs, Logitech with the peripherals, so keyboards, great keyboards, mice, some audio stuff, and controllers. A lot of good things from Logitech, and also Sennheiser doing the headsets. Last but not least, Match Arena. You can donate money to increase the prize pool. We also do have the stretch goals. So if you donate enough, we will have Reynald versus Forsen playing on stream. We can also play some musical chairs on stream. And you don't even have to donate, I think. You can just click donate and put a code here, which is Seed Story, lowercase. And I think not everybody uses the Seed Story, so you can still increase the funds with $1 per Seed Story. And that will be it about the promotion, guys. So now we're back, and let's talk about the matchup. So you guys said Eloise is favored. What are they playing? What are the bans?
They're both playing the same lineup, both playing Mage, Shaman, Warlock, and Warrior. So Naiman decided to ban the Warlock of Eloise, and Eloise decided to ban the Warrior of Naiman. I think Eloise should be favored because she still has the Warrior, and the Warrior has like a sweet potential on the Mage, Shaman, and Warlock.
Yep.
And the Warlock is also pretty good, but it's hard to win versus Warrior, so I think Eloise should be favored.
Chino, do you agree?
Yeah, absolutely. I think the Warrior is really strong in those matchups.
All right, so the game now, game one starts now. There is the Aggro Shaman from Eloise, and Naiman is playing his Shaman as well. So Aggro versus Aggro, it seems, right?
Fun matchup.
Yeah, it is a fun matchup, actually, because normally this deck is a face deck, but in this matchup you trade a lot.
Yeah, it's really going to come down to who gets the board and can keep putting just the chip damage in from the board position. It's not that much about the face damage, more like a resource battle, I'd say.
All right, and what are the cards you need in the beginning? What are the best cards you can mulligan for?
I think like just your early game, one or two mana minions. Rockbiter is a really good keep, so you can just remove that Tunnel Truck that comes out on turn one. Just the Totem Golem, of course. Feral Spirits, you sometimes keep it if you have like Tunnel Truck and to coin Feral Spirits, you can keep it.
All right.
I see Eloise has a really good hand here.
Yeah, she has a really nice start. And Chinoys, what do you think about hand from Naiman?
Yeah, I think the Sentinel is not that important in the early game, but there is the Totem Golem, very good pickup. But yeah, I think the Tunnel Truck is, you have to remove it. This is also something questionable. We discussed it like 20 minutes ago. Like, Mitsuhide and me don't like steady shot in the mirror because you really fight for board and you actually don't smork as a face shaman.
So what are the best hero powers you can get? Fire Blast, Shapeshift, possibly Laser Heal as well?
I think Lifetap is one of the best. Because in the like turn 5, both shamans should be really low on cards. So if you can just refill with the Lifetap, it's really nice.
So basically a resource battle, and you don't go face that much, so you have still some life as a shaman.
No, it's a bit like the Zoo Mirror. You just make good trades, and you just try to stick the board, and then when you have the board, you can just push face with the minions you have.
All right, so now we know the secrets of this matchup. There is Totem Golem to counter this Trog. On the other hand, Eloise, that's just a Lightning Storm, and Lightning Storm is a recent addition to the face shaman decks. What do you guys think? Do you play one? Do you play two? What do you cut from the deck?
I haven't played it yet in face shaman. At DreamHack, I played one Elemental Destruction. But yeah, in this meta right now, with a lot of Zoo, with a lot of face shaman, midrange shaman, I think Lightning Storm is really strong.
Yeah, I think Eloise could maybe two Horse Riders for two Lightning Storms. Namon is running the Sentinel list, which we saw like in the NA prelims a while back, which is like Sentinels and then one Elemental Destruction in it. Also some more card draw in the Ancestral Knowledges. So I think Namon should have the better deck for the mirror because he has like more card draw, but the Storms are also pretty good.
He might not have Think from Below in the deck. Right?
Yeah, I don't think so.
No, I don't think so.
I don't think he has discard Totemic either.
Yeah, if you play Sentinels, you don't, especially with Ancestral Knowledge. All right, so you can't really deal, or you can deal with it.
Yeah, it's abusive. But you're really weak against the Lightning Storm of Eloise.
Yep. But I think at this point, Namon should be ahead because he has the Doom Hammer and as I said, it's like a resource battle, and the Doom Hammer gives a lot of value on board. Just for one card.
Eloise can play the next 7-7 though, next turn.
Yeah, like, that top deck is huge.
Yeah. Lightning Storm this turn. Next turn, she has 4 mana for this next 7-7.
It would be hard to deal with another next 7-7, but there is the distraction, and you can, in theory, play the Doom Hammer here to start doing some face damage.
He decides to go face. I like that. With the hero power especially, I can push 6 damage per turn. So he can start the raise already. And if the board gets out of hand, he can just use the destruction to clear it.
In theory, because there is now a 7-7. So
yeah. Now it's harder.
That 7-7 is huge in this matchup, especially if you can't deal with it.
So yeah, Namon decides the hero power. I like that. Pushes 2 more face damage.
So he's either racing or forcing Eloise to trade into his 3-4. And if she trades into his 3-4, he has a mental destruction.
Yeah. I think he wants Eloise to trade because then he can just clear the board.
Terry
leaves the 1-1, but it's fine.
So now it's back on Eloise. Normally you would kind of want to trade because your opponent is so aggressive. Stoneclaw Totem is nice.
Yeah. Also, that Rockbiter is really nice. Like, she can, if she wants, trade with a Squire and a Rockbiter in the 3-4 and go for 7 face.
Yeah, that's a nice clue.
And there is nothing that can really kill the 7-7 there, because even Elemental Destruction deals 4 damage. You can combine it with, like, no single card can deal with it. You can obviously combine cards, like Lightning Bolt and Elemental Destruction can deal with it.
Yeah. Ooh, that's a great draw. Now you can just use the Feral Spirit to tank the 7 damage.
Yeah.
You can just start racing.
And Eloise has no cards in hand.
I think he's considering to just hero powers and
just clear the
seven tree.
Yeah, that's actually really great.
You will still have 4 mana next turn, even with this overload, so you will be able to play Feral Spirit next turn.
Yeah.
And 12 is not that dangerous if you play versus this kind of deck. Eloise has no draw, but she might get something. She might get Lifetap here. That would be big.
Yeah, Lifetap would be huge.
That's an Armor Up, Laser Heal, and Shapeshift. So no Lifetap there, but
I think you pick the Shapeshift.
Yeah, especially if you pick up Doomhammer, Shapeshift can push a lot of damage, and it heals for 1.
Yeah, it heals you and you can use it to clear some small minions off the board.
And most of the cards you draw as Alois from the top are going to be damage cards. This is a shaman that deals damage.
Yeah, definitely. I think what Alois is looking for here is like her own feral spirits or maybe a thing from below.
Doomhammer?
Or Doomhammer. That would be great as well.
Ooh, that really fits the curve.
Yeah.
Yeah, that's
awesome.
Great.
Awesome draw for Nyman from Virtus Pro.
I like Nyman just keeping the charge here of the Doomhammer so he can get one extra damage with hero power next turn, or if he top decks a Rockbiter, he has almost guaranteed lethal.
And Alois, meanwhile, getting abusive, that will help her clear one of the wolves.
Yeah, it's nice to trade, but I don't think that's exactly what she's looking for.
So there is 13 damage from Nyman after losing the wolf. Alois can go up to 17, so this means 4 damage will win the game.
Yeah.
4 damage being Lava Burst, Flame Tongue Totem, Rock Biter.
Yeah. She really needed her second Lightning Storm and roll high, because now there's not a lot of potential to come back.
Yeah, and a lot of potential for Nyman to actually get something. Even Lightning Bolt can win him the game because it buffs the Trog. Tons of outs to just finish the game right now. And even if he misses the something big, he can still put himself in a good position.
Yeah, exactly. So what will it... Oh, that's lethal.
Yeah?
Wow.
So you guys mentioned at the beginning that Nyman is at the disadvantage matchup-wise because of the Warrior, but does the fact that he won against the Shaman and eliminated Eloise's Shaman put him on edge now? Or is it still troublesome, that Warrior?
I think the Shaman... For both players, the Shaman is not expected to get a lot of wins because they're both playing Zoo and Warrior. Well, they both got one band, but... And Mage is pretty good against Shaman, so... I wouldn't say it's too bad for Eloise. She didn't expect to pick up a lot of wins with the Shaman anyway. Like, it's really bad if she loses her first game with Warrior, for example, because she kind of has to get a lot of wins with that deck. But losing with the Shaman is okay.
Yeah, Warrior will be the key deck, and Eloise is Bible thumping. She seems so sad.
Yeah, they're just putting on the poker face, right? Like in last game with Naaman versus Ekop.
Yeah. What are you guys rooting for? Do you root for Eloise or Nyman?
I have to say Nyman.
Nyman?
Yeah, same.
Why? Any reasons?
Well, he's just my friend. I talk to him a lot, so...
Oh, okay. Yeah. That's a good reason. So I will root for Eloise then. What teams are you on, by the way? Oh, you're not on teams, right? Because you're not participating in the event?
Nope.
Okay, so there is Team Anubis and Team Horus. Which team would you like to be on?
Nyman is on Team Anubis, and now they are both on Team Anubis.
So I want to be on Anubis. It's a dog.
Eloise is Team Horus, I believe. I think so, because I'm not sure, actually. Most of the Tempo Storm is Team Horus, but... Well, go Team Horus!
Yeah.
And right now, Eloise is thinking about the matchup, because this might be hard. What would you guys open with? You don't want to lose your Warrior.
So you want to counter the Shaman.
I would probably go with a Mage. I think you really want a Warrior against like the Warlock.
I think the Warrior is better because Warrior should be better versus Shaman than Mage. Depends on what kind of... Okay, so it could be Dragon or Tempo Warrior. Both are fine against aggro Shaman.
She has the War Axe.
Yeah, she has a really good hand.
So Warrior versus Shaman, what do you guys think? Is it like favoring Warrior? Is it more of a 50-50?
I'd say it's like maybe 60-40 for the Warrior.
60-40 for... Yeah. Shino, do you agree?
Yeah. 60-40, 55-45.
It really depends if the Warrior can get like the Alexstrasza's Champion or War Axe. Like if you deal with the early pressure, it's usually not that hard to keep up.
And you have executes for 7-7, so basically you put up with the tempo and then Shaman has to use spells to kill your minions and you just go face, so...
Yep. Like, this juggle is so important. Now she had...
Yeah, it's really huge.
She has 2 free trades. It's just insane.
Yeah, this is already tough for Nyman with this board. And Eloise still has the coin. She has the Drake. She can either go for Frothing or maybe even Fireworks. She has a lot of options next turn.
Yep. As Nyman, I would consider playing the Abusive. It's really bad against the turn 3 Ghoul, but at this point you're behind, so I don't think you can play around that, and you want to follow it up with the turn 4 Flame Wreathed Faceless.
Well, if you see a turn 3 Ghoul, you're happy.
Yeah.
That board, yes. You are.
You're like, Abusive. Oh, maybe she'll forget and play a turn 3 Ghoul.
This is an interesting turn.
Would you consider going Twilight Guardian into the Twilight Guardian? Like,
yeah, but the second one... Oh, no, you have the Fairy Dragon. Yeah,
yeah, the Fairy Dragon.
Yeah, that's why it's now active.
Like,
I would definitely consider it. Not sure if it's the best play.
I think this play is nice as well.
Yeah, buffing Frothing to 4-4, which does not die to the 3-4. And next turn, you can play Twilight Guardian and protect your Frothing behind it.
Yep.
So it might be even better. And one of the answers here would be, like, what can Shaman do to really kill the 4-4? If Shaman plays, let's say, Flame Tongue Totem and trades, you're like, sure, I just kill the Flame Tongue. If Shaman uses like a Lightning Bolt, he overloads himself. Lava Burst is terrible. So there weren't that many good answers.
That's what I really like about Midrange Shaman. One Stormcrack, because I really think Stormcrack. It's one of the better removal cards at the moment, like Imgang Boss, Pillager, Frothing. Like, everything has 4 health of OP minions. And yeah, the Totem Golem, of course, to turn 2.
So do you go with Twilight Guardian here, or do you just go for War Axe and take the good trade and follow it up with the Fairy Dragon? Oh, that's also a possibility.
Well,
you kind of give up your Frothing?
I think I would go for Guardian, honestly.
Yeah, same.
Yeah, same.
But Naaman doesn't really have a good hand. He can use the Rockbiter to clear, but it's so passive.
Yeah, the Elemental Distraction is not that amazing versus Dragon Warrior. Dragon Warrior mostly has 1 to 2 minions, so it's not like it has to overextend.
Yeah.
7-7 will be nice, because there is no Execute, but if Execute comes at any point of this game, it will be really bad. For Nyman.
Oh
my god! I'm so sorry, Nyman. Go, Eloise! So Eloise decides not to play the Fairy Dragon because she can play Twilight Guardians if she's 6 Dawns.
Yeah, I think she was considering perhaps coining the War Axe as well, so she can follow it up with the Guardian and the Fairy Dragon.
Can you take 7 to activate the Execute here?
I think I would, actually.
Yeah, I think it's fine. You can just play the Guardian, War Axe, Coin Execute.
Yeah, you have armor up, so even if you go down to, what, like 17? Nyman only has 2 cards, and you should be able to recover, especially with the board.
Yeah, and you're pushing damage, like, you're ahead a lot, I think.
And I don't like attacking into the Sansan with this 3-6 or using your Korokron. Seems wasteful.
Yeah, the taunt is in a way also kind of your life total, right?
Yeah. This is a bit more damage this turn, and you're more aggressive than playing Twilight Guardian.
Yeah, I think this is a really good play.
Korokron is better than...
It's a bit weaker to a Lightning Bolt, but on the other hand, if anything that doesn't go face is fine at this point for the Warrior.
So Nyman can play Elemental Destruction and then play Sentinel.
And Hero Power.
And Hero Power. Does it do much? Like, it heals the 4-3, it damages the 3-6. It doesn't do that much, though. So...
This is interesting.
This is preparing the board for Elemental Destruction next turn.
I wonder if Eloise knows that Nyman is running Elemental Destruction.
I'm not sure if he has shown it in his match versus the Cup.
I think they do, like...
I think she will play around it.
And you see all the pro players, they were like studying every single card, writing every single card they see in a matchup, so... I wouldn't be surprised if she knows.
Only Forsen was surprised by this giant.
You can consider trading with the 4-3 here, instead of with the 3-4.
Well, you can kill it with the weapon as well.
Yeah, you could do that too.
So
I think you value the weapon more than the life on the Korokron. And you value your own life as well.
She just goes playing space. I think I really like that.
Now that you don't trade, I don't think you should play the Twilight Guardian. Because then the 2-1 just trades into it and the destruction clears everything.
Well, the thing is, weapon is also damage to face and Shaman is at 9. So you might play one fiery dragon, and if elemental destruction clears your board, you suppose your opponent not to do much afterwards. But she
knows.
Wow, that's the perfect draw. Now you can just Feral Spirit and clear off the overload with the Sentinel.
Yeah. So this game is not over yet.
No, it isn't.
Eloise still has an advantage because this turn she can play Guardian, kill one of the wolves.
Yeah, I really like the hero power. Like, you want the hero power every single turn now.
I don't.
Also,
I would have played the Sentinel there because the Sentinel plays deals 3 damage next turn, so it's 1 more damage.
Maybe he's trying to conceal the fact that he will actually have mana next turn and try to play the Eloise into a mistake. Like, this is a small thing, but
playing the mind games.
Yeah, playing the mind games. Like, I have only 2 mana next turn. I cannot do anything, and then ta-da, Sentinel. Whole turn.
So I think you just play double Fairy Dragon here. Or maybe 1 Fairy Dragon and armor up if you're scared.
1 armor up probably because of Corruptors.
Yeah, no card can really kill you. No combination of 2 cards. So I think you just play both.
The thing is only that you actually lose the dragon from your hand. So you make some of the cards that you can draw weaker.
Yeah, but that's true.
Those cards are, like, she used double Twilight Guardian already, so those are Corruptors. Is there anything else that actually has advantage because of the buff? Not really. So
yeah,
maybe
actually... Perhaps the 6-6 taunt, but I don't know if she's playing that.
Yeah.
I don't think so.
So probably second dragon made sense. And now you can actually slam Ghoul and go 6 to face.
She would have had lethal, right, if she played the Fairy Dragon?
Yes.
But of course she can know that she would top deck the slam.
She can get a weapon, maybe. Oh, Frothing. Frothing is interesting. You can Frothing and Ghoul.
Yeah, I really like that.
I think seeing her line of play from the past turn, I think she will go for the armor up still. Like Ghoul, Fairy Dragon armor up.
But there's nothing that can kill you, right?
Like, yeah, true.
Double Lava Burst, Hero Power is one off.
I will also like trade the 3-2 into 3-2 afterwards.
Yeah, I like that.
Well, if she goes for hero power, then she doesn't have to trade. But if I go for Frothing Ghoul, then I definitely trade a 3-2 into 3-2.
Maybe she's thinking about a second elemental destruction?
Yeah, that's probably what she's playing around. Because she's really careful about playing minions. Oh,
there it is.
Ooh.
Oh, that's so close. It's so far away at the same time.
Naaman can prevent lethal for 1 more turn, but it's not game winning.
It's not game winning.
I think you just concede at this point.
Yeah. There's no way to win.
Lava Burst, don't face.
The honorable Sudoku.
That's always a good way to go down. But Naaman doesn't give up. He prevents the lethal. He still has a way to survive this turn.
Oh.
So trade into the 3-1. You have no options, but maybe the Eloise will not have
Romash,
options.
Romash,
well.
Ragnaros.
Oh,
yeah.
Aurex.
All right, so Eloise is able to win with that warrior, and this warrior might be the demise of Naaman because Dragon Warrior is so strong currently in the metagame. It's really hard to counter it. If I would give you guys one chance, one deck to counter Dragon Warrior, what would you bring? Chino's first.
Reno Lock. Yeah, I'm really big Reno Lock fan, and I think Reno Lock beats every warrior except the OTK warrior that's really popular right now.
All right, Mitsuhide, what would you bring?
I think I would bring some sort of control warrior, maybe Cthulhu warrior.
Okay.
Seems good against it. You can just get out of reach with the huge armor gain.
Those decks are not that popular at CSR Cup 5, so it will be really hard to counter Dragon then.
Yeah. Oh, we see
Enzot's
first mage, yeah. That's interesting.
So she's playing the more aggressive version. She might even
also
have a
really
good
against Zoo.
Yeah.
Yep.
That's why she banned Warrior from Naaman.
Yeah, that makes sense. So do you Arcane Blast this?
I hope not.
It seems like a real waste, especially when you have Flame Waker, Coin, Arcane Blast.
Yeah, and you have, like, Ping.
Yeah.
But the thing with the tempo mage is that you want to accumulate some cards, and Naiman is definitely happy by the fact that he has the coin in hand. So just accumulate a couple of cards and be able to have one big swing turn.
Yeah, you're probably just paying the 1-1.
I think so. You have a nice setup though. You can Arcane Intellect or Torch into Flamewalker, Coin, Mirror Images, and Arcane Blast.
Yeah.
Tempo cool?
it seems so bad.
Yeah. I wouldn't do it, but it's helping the Flamewalker.
I think it's just Arcane Intellect here.
You can definitely do that. This board is not as threatening. You've seen just Eloise almost pass the turn.
On the other hand, if you go for Flamewalker, Coin, Mirror Images, you have four missiles, so it's pretty decent as well.
A good chance to kill the 3-2.
Yep, and if it doesn't kill it, it's still your Flamewalker is still not challenged on board.
Yeah. And she misses
wow.
it. Oh, he misses it.
But like next turn, he has Mana Worm. He can combine it with Forgotten Torch or Arcane Blast. Or even with Arcane Intellect.
Oh, we can actually kill this Flamewaker here easily because Alexstrasza's a champion, so she can execute.
Yep.
It's worth it.
I think you definitely need to get rid of that Flamewaker.
Yeah. And Naiman doesn't play Ragnaros, I think, in his Tempo Mage. His biggest threats are Emperor.
So is he playing Kabbalah Stone?
Yeah, he's playing, I think, one copy of Kabbalah Stone.
Oh man, that missed Flamewaker on the 3-1. This 3-1 is just there punishing Naiman. So maybe it was better to wait, but as you said, Mr. Hyde, it was actually a good chance to kill it with four missiles.
I think you just trade with the 3-1 and play Azure Drake here.
Yeah.
Probably the best. You have the dragon still in your hand now because you have Fiery Dragon.
Wow, the Blackwing one turn too late.
It's still awesome.
Yeah, it's still good.
Next turn is still good. So what do you do as Naiman?
I would probably Arcane Intellect here.
I think versus the Dragon Warrior, you kind of have to fight for the board. Yeah, I like this. Otherwise, you just give so much initiative to the Warrior.
So now you can actually Coraptor and attack into it. You have a 4-1, which is frozen and demands some attention at least. What else you can do?
It would be so good if she had one mana extra. She could just slam Coraptor it.
Yeah.
Weapon attack, yeah.
No weapon attack because of the spell damage of Azure Drake.
Oh, you're right.
It would be insane. But like now, I think this is a bit of a hard turn.
Yeah.
6 health is a lot for the Warrior.
Yeah, you still Corruptor it, I think.
Still Corruptor. No attack into it? No trade? Well, in a way it makes sense because you put damage near your opponent and he will have to attack with his Water Elemental into something.
And it's one turn too early for the Flame Strike, so
you start off with Intellect.
He eats something here. Because something with spell damage wouldn't be bad, because then you can Arcane Blast one of the four health creatures, but he didn't get it, so.
So, maybe you want to set up for a Flame Strike. Just go face with the Water Elemental.
Well, you can clear if you get perfect missiles.
Yeah, that's actually true. Okay, so he decides to just torch one minion.
So Naiman is saying to Eloise, hey, you won't kill my Water Elemental, I won't kill your Azure Drake, let's just go face and ignore the minions. Playing the game of chicken. Whoever attacks into this Water Elemental first. And now he actually stopped the weapon in a way.
That's a really good slam though.
Yeah, solid.
So she's considering armoring up or equipping the War Axe. Equipping the War Axe makes sense because she wants to go for Grom next turn.
Yeah. And she will be able to go for Grom. And she is in no danger of dying. Naiman, on the other hand.
Yeah, I like this Flame Strike.
have a naked Grommash. Or
no dragon in hand. Yeah, Grommash is fine, obviously.
Yeah, she sets up Lethal for next turn with the Ghoul.
And then Diamond will have to answer this Grommash. Oh, ooh, there's the rock. Praise the Yogg.
So how many missiles do you need to hit?
Like one, actually. Like you have Arcane Blast in worst case.
Oh no, you can just clear it with the ping. And Arcane Blast.
Yeah, if you want to use... Like, do you value Arcane Blast more or less than the Arcane Missiles?
I think you value the Arcane Blast higher, probably.
Yeah. So because it's targeted damage. So you start with missiles first?
Yeah, I think so.
Start with missiles, see what they get. Is there anything you can get from Kabbalah's Tome? Not really.
Yeah, you could get like Polymorph Boar, but it would still be 7 damage on board.
Yeah.
So, yeah.
All right, he just goes for a clean clear, I guess.
Is he praying to Yogg?
I hope we get to see another Yogg.
Yeah, that would be awesome.
Yesterday, Naaman wasn't that lucky. He told me he got, what's it called? The 4-mana Druid card.
Ancestral Communion?
Yeah, Communion. Twice?
Yeah, twice. But yes. I had many Yoggs in my life. I never got Communion, I think.
Oh, I get it all the time.
But last match is, Yogg was insane. Like, Whispers, the 7-1 ones, Evolve, and...
Yeah,
that one was insane.
And it seems like we are going to see that Yogg, because I don't see Eloise winning next turn. Naaman still has tools to be able to stop this board. Mm-hmm. Now, the only question is, how do you combine all of this? I see Frostbolt on the 5-4, but is he thinking about Kabbalah's Tome?
Emperor, because it kind of forces Eloise to trade into it, and you can't really afford to take any more face damage at this point. And next turn, you can still just Arcane Missiles plus Yogg if you want to.
Yeah, Eloise doesn't have that many options of her own at the moment. If she goes 6 to face, she puts him on 5, but it's tough. She might pick up a dragon to get like Alexstrasza champion going to face, but this is a far shot. And obviously, Torresen is a minion that's going to deal damage on board. Do you guys think she can actually trade with Torresen?
No, I don't think so.
Because if she trades...
So
there's so many ways to actually win this game for Naaman now.
Yeah, it was looking really good for Eloise a few turns back, but now... Yeah. If the Yogg is good, the tables are turned.
Well, Naaman is not good.
Naaman might not even have to go Yogg.
Yeah, he could look for like a Blizzard or something, maybe.
Yeah, from Kabbalah's Tome, six mana left. Exactly. That's a Polymorph to deal with the 5-4, and then you can double missile.
It's 8 missiles plus a ping. If you're lucky, you clear the entire board. But if the frotting sticks, you're kind of behind a lot. You're probably dead.
I think you just polymorph the frotting and go to 0 mana missiles.
Yeah, this is
and
a good play.
If it doesn't hit the 5-1, you can just ping it.
Yeah, exactly. And then you stabilize more or less.
You can also be more greedy, but no, I like this. You could go for like the Telnos 1 extra missile. This is better.
I think what Chino suggested is a bit better because you can get unlucky and then 5 damage to face might be deadly. So you have to ensure you're able to kill the 5-1. Ooh, Ragnaros.
Wow.
That's 8 damage to face.
She's actually 1 damage off of the 50-50.
Now I think we will see a Yogg.
Well, yes.
Yeah.
You have to.
Unless Naaman picks up Frostbolt, he can actually deal with the Ragnaros.
With the Shatter.
Yeah.
Yeah, but...
This seems Yogg like time. A good Yogg Saron. Praise Yogg!
Mind control.
RNG gods.
Oh.
That will give him armor. That buffs a creature. Doesn't actually matter that much. Oh, Pyroblast goes somewhere. And first doesn't do much. He needs to get rid of that Ragnaros.
Almost.
Yeah.
Lava Shock can be deadly.
Wrong.
Vaporize doesn't do that much. Sap doesn't do that much. Sap is
bad.
Actually terrible.
Yeah,
Sap
is terrible.
So bad!
And there is no card like Yu-Gi-Oh! You discard your whole hand.
Yeah, so he basically needs an ice block and he does not get it and that will be it. So Naaman not really happy about it. Yeah, that sucks for Naiman.
Yep, that's just game.
But it means Team Horus and Eloise is getting that game. Unless she thinks this is Ice Block and is afraid to do this, or like Mirror Entity. But this is just Viper Eyes. Because this could have been any secret. And if there is a Mirror Entity...
Yeah, then you go for the 50-50, and if you hit it, it's fine. If you miss it, it's like you have just to win.
All right, Eloise takes the lead here, 2-1 versus Naiman. So, guys, as you said, this Warrior is great. He's doing great. Can Naiman stop it with his last tech?
Warlock.
It's a zoo.
Ooh, that's gonna be tough, I think.
Yeah.
Really tough.
When I want to counter zoo, I take Dragon Warrior.
Yeah, it's a really good counter. Like, every kind of warrior is pretty good again. Yeah, except phase warrior. Other kinds are all good versus zoo.
Also, Eloise has extra addition to counter it because she has Nezahl's first mate also.
Yep. Does she run Finley?
I don't remember.
I don't think so.
We've seen Finley in Shaman, but...
Yeah, perhaps he just got Finley for the Nezahl's first mate. Wow, and Eloise's hand is really good. But it's a bit awkward with the Nezahl's first mate and the War Axe. But I think you still play it.
Yeah, it's a 1-1 is fine against Zoo, I think. Yep. Like.
And after turn 1 is pretty worthless.
You counter every 1-drop. No, you don't counter Voidwalker, but every other 1-drop you just kill it.
Yep.
So it's really good. And even you don't really, like, even if there is a Voidwalker, you can slam it next turn.
Yep.
So I like first mate here from Eloise. We'll see if she decides to play it or not.
Yeah. It's a hard decision when you have War Axe, but I really think you need to go for it.
There's just too many good situations for you. And I like the attack as well, obviously, because you kind of want to play War Axe at some point.
Yeah. So usually, as a zoo versus warrior, you want to go like 1-drop into coin 3-drop, because they usually can deal with the 3-drop. But in this case, it's really awkward to play the villager, it just gets traded away.
And that fairy dragon is also really good.
Yep.
Yeah. Even though she will not have dragons in hand, it's still better to play it to be on board versus zoo.
Ooh, the peddler is really good. I think any other card would have been pretty mediocre here.
Yeah, Peddler at least trades into the 3-2.
Horse Rider would have been alright, I guess.
So what's the best choice?
I think Elven Archer, actually.
Yeah, maybe you go for Dragon Egg with the Defender in hand.
Yeah, I was thinking about that as well. You will never get the board, a big enough board to play Seeker as a 5-5. Elven Archer...
Yeah, what I have a lot is when you play a Zoo Imgang boss, they play Corcoran lead, and that 1-1 will be removed by the weapon or another minion. Then you have that Elven Archer to deal that one extra damage to the Corcoran lead.
Oh, okay.
So yeah, that's true.
That's the one damage is missing. Yeah, that's fair point. So there was definitely some merit for this Elven Archer. But Egg is also good, not only with Defender Vargas, but against Ravaging Ghoul. It's awkward on board for the Warrior.
So yeah, just Darksire, Coin, Egg. And what Naiman praised for here is that the Darkshire survives, but it obviously won't.
Well, there is a weapon and a minion board that can easily kill it, but... Slam is even better, or do you just go for Corcoran?
I would go for Corcoran and with the weapon hit, and 3-2 Ghost Face.
I like that as well.
Meanwhile, on the other stream, the secondary stream, we have Thais versus Ustkaka, which I believe is the decider in a way that the winner advances to the top 8 tomorrow, because Thais was able to win versus Hoi, getting 4 Totem Golems from Tusker Totemic.
From four Tusker Totemic.
That's in a row, sick. In one match.
Oh, that's insane. I would be pretty happy with that.
Yep. So, I think as long as Eloise doesn't pick up a whirlwind, Naiman should be fine with the rituals. He has the Direwolf to buff them up. He has the PO. He can trade most of the stuff away in a few turns.
The thing is, you don't know if she has the ghoul or not, so
yeah,
it's a bit clunky to play ritual.
I think sometimes when you are so behind, you just have to take those risks.
Yeah, I agree.
Like now, Direwolf and...
Oh, that's interesting.
Oh, that means Ritual is pretty good overall. Ooh. Oh, now...
Coils.
Coil.
I don't think you Coil, actually.
Are you still
Ritual?
I think
you just Ritual, yeah.
Yeah.
Because if Eloise plays Ghoul or something, the 4-1 dies as well. And you just get one extra 1-1, which trades for the 4-1, and you keep the Coil for trading later on.
Yeah, true. I would just go for Ritual as well.
But I can also understand Naaman's thought. He has like a pretty bad hand, I would say. So maybe he wants to fish for some useful cards.
Well, he's definitely not happy about double PO of the top. We just won minis. Oh my god!
Soulfire, wow.
Yeah, at least the Ritual stayed. So now he has some kind of a board. But just getting double PO and the Soulfire off the top feels bad. But in this situation, actually, it's actually good for him.
Yep, the double frotting is going to be really good, though.
There is the ghoul, but a bit too late.
Yep. Maybe you just go face here as Naaman. Just put the double direwolf, top double direwolf. Just go full face.
Well, with double direwolf, you can actually kill one of the frottings with the defender, right. And then just soulfire the second one, and then go face. It's still awesome.
Yeah, that's actually probably better, yeah. Yeah, I didn't even see that play.
He can play his whole hand, actually.
Well, you probably cannot play PO, because there's no need.
Do you value...
But if you soulfire, you will discard a card.
Yeah, so. I think I would prefer a 3-2 taunt on board.
Yeah, I think so too.
First hit up.
So he's not going to play soulfire?
Yeah, I guess no soulfire. Just kill one of the frottings and go face with the rest.
Yeah, I like that too. You set up lethal.
Unless he just goes face with everything, this is what, like 10 damage?
I think that is so risky, to least two four things up.
Yeah.
Especially when you get the free trade.
Yeah, that's a really nice clean kill.
Okay, let's go back to 2015, OTK.
Yeah, double whirlwind.
Yeah, double ghoul. No, it was never lethal, but it was a lot of damage.
Yeah, it would be full board clear, so.
Wow, and this win is also super important. Not only because he just saves himself, but the warrior will be gone. And then the last deck for Eloise will be her mage?
Mage, yeah.
But the Twilight Guardian is really good here. Though Naaman has a PO.
So... Yeah, she's not dead if she plays the Ghoul and the Guardian. Perhaps she even just slam a 2-2.
Well, Ghoul and Guardian, and you trade in the 3-2, so you have left two dogs and a 3-1 on board. Because you will lose the frotting.
Yeah, Ghoul's probably better than Slam. Because you develop a minion as well. But I can see this, yeah.
She just wants the frotting to survive, I believe.
The placement by Naaman was really nice, so that the Direwolf is still in the middle.
I think I like that play from Eloise, because you actually preserve your frotting to be at 2 health, so it doesn't die to Ghoul next turn.
Yep. Yeah, that's actually really smart. But it can get traded away on board.
Yeah, but then Naaman will have to sacrifice the full board. Mm-hmm. In theory, at least, because right now he has that Juggler and Peddler. I think it's still top, yeah. Mm.
Wasn't it better to just play your entire hand, clear the board, use Soulfire? And PO. And just tap after? I don't know.
Maybe you're right, actually.
Well, he will not lose the board by playing like this. Like, he still has board. He's still 4 mana. He can go to Councilman and to Voidwalker.
And kill the 9-2.
And kill the Rotting.
Yeah.
I think you kill it, yeah.
Yeah, you should.
You definitely kill it, but the play was okay, I guess.
Placement is good.
Councilman is such a scary minion.
Yeah, it is a really scary minion. So what do? You answer Drake first, then you can Batsuikr the dog. Unless you get execute, then maybe execute. Oh man, no dragon for now. She's still alive though.
So how much damage does Naaman need?
That's 3 damage on board, 4 damage in hand, that's 7.
Is PO lethal?
Oh, actually, Crazed Alchemist might be lethal. You can swap the stats of the Councilman.
I think he still needs maybe an Abusive. Let's count.
So if you play Crazed Alchemist, you swap the stats to 5-2 and it gets buffed, right? So it's a 6-2.
Six.
You have 7 damage on board. You need 8 more. You have 4 from...
Yeah, Abusive is enough.
So you play...
So Abusive, Soulfire, PO.
So Alchemist first? Alchemist first.
You're Alchemist first.
And then you Peddler?
Yep.
Was that Elven Archer lethal now, or...?
So I guess he's just going for the safe play.
And there is no... So far, no Abusive and no PO.
I think she's just big Flame Imp.
Yeah, Flame Imp.
Well, this is still an awesome situation for Naaman, whatever happens, even if he doesn't find lethal, because he is full on board and there is nothing that Eloise normally can do with this deck. Like, Deathwing is not the time for Deathwing. There is no Brawl in the deck. Maybe Double Ghoul can clear, but not really. Execute is something, but is it enough? Not really.
It's not enough.
I know. Wait.
Oh.
So she can...
Execute the 5-5, because that's the biggest
five,
target.
5-5 and the 1-3, and then there are the 2-1, 2-1, 3-1, and the Soulfire. Yeah. So
it's not enough.
Yeah, from her from her perspective, maybe she's still alive because there is, what, 5-7 damage on board, so she hopes there is nothing else to pull up, but we know that with Soulfire, Naaman is able to tie the series.
So we're going to a fifth game.
Yes. And that game is going to be Zoo versus Mage. Mage from Eloise, which is also a tempo mage, kind of like, I've heard, a Chinese mage, which means it has more draw, Kabbalah Stone, right?
It's probably worse against Zoo because you have like a bit more... like value cards, like Kabbalah's Tome against Warrior and Druid. And you probably cut, I don't know, maybe cut like one Flame Strike or something. So it should be a bit worse against Zoo.
Well, in general, this matchup is bad for a Tempo Mage.
Yeah.
Zoo has
an
advantage because of cards like Imp Gang Boss and at an early start. Also depends who has the coin. If Eloise would love to have the coin as a mage.
Yeah, the coin is great.
And
she gets it.
She gets a coin, yeah.
So, yeah, you keep the Flame Waker, sure.
Naaman has a decent start.
I saw an Ice Block. That was really fast, but I saw an Ice Block.
Yeah, I think she plays one Ice Block in her mage list. It gives you one more time to Yogg. One more turn. It's like on turn 9 you play Ice Block, they don't kill you, you Yogg next turn.
Oh.
Yeah, I've seen that tech before. It's an interesting tech overall. Like, it just gives you time, right?
Yeah.
Like, just set it up somewhere in the mid-game and then just have one more turn maybe to finish the kill.
What Naaman really wants here is a 3-drop. Imp Gang Boss is so good against Tempo Mage.
Yeah, even Councilman wouldn't be bad because then on fork he can play Ritual. But he might be forced to play Ritual on 3.
Yeah,
just play the 3-2.
Do you
3-2 seems fine.
Do you want to play 3-2 or do you keep 3-2 for like Apprentice, Flame Waker turn?
I don't think you have time for that.
I think next turn you're probably looking to just play Flame Waker, coin, Mirror Images.
Maybe Mirror Images this turn to protect it? No, you just want to lose it?
Yeah, I think you're fine. The Nightmare scenario would be a Direwolf, but... Abusive is fine because she can just clear it with the missiles next turn.
So from Naaman's perspective, who is really good at his tempo mage, do you just kill the 3-2?
Yeah, I think you have to kill it.
Yeah, you really have to kill it.
So kill it but and play Ritual, I guess?
Yeah, Naaman is praying at this point that Eloise doesn't have any missiles, so he can set up for the Gormok next turn. But we know Eloise is going to have a lot of missiles.
Yeah.
To be exact.
Well, for Naaman, the perfect turn from Eloise's perspective would be just to play Water Elemental, right? But he decides he will not risk Flame Waker into missiles or Flame Waker coin, whatever spell, and to lose the board.
And that Imp Gang Boss is a bit too late. That was really strong.
Yeah, that would be insane on turn 3.
Yeah, and now Firework, Mage.
Yeah, this is so insane. Naaman really needs a Soulfire here to just clear the Flame Waker.
That's also good.
Yeah, Flame Waker can fill the curve at least. And Aloy suddenly has Ice Block for the next turn. For now at least.
Ooh, Flame Strike.
Flame Strike sometimes wins this matchup.
I don't think I would go for Ice Block. I would go for Dalnos. Probably Ping. Ping the 1-3.
Yep, I like that. You're also kind of looking for more cards.
Yeah, and it's one ping less, actually. And you can choose where the ping goes.
Okay. And Iceberg obviously can ping the Imp Gang boss, so...
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
You don't want to put more power on board.
Yeah, the 1-1s that would spawn trade just so well into the images.
Defender of Argus, does it change anything here? It's just a really good minion, and if Gangboss gets bigger and bigger.
Yeah. This needs a fireball, I think, for the Gangboss now.
Frostbolt
for 4 damage.
It's alright.
Yeah, Frostbolt, Ice Block eventually. Or if you need it, you can just ping, but no, you have 2 more pings if you just play Ice Block.
Yeah, it's frozen anyway, so you can just ping it next turn.
Well, that's awkward.
I think I would go for the Ice Block. It's 2 pings. If it hits the 2-2, you can go in with Blood Mage. If it doesn't, you go with Flame Waker and your Talons goes into the 3-1 or the 1-1.
At least you're getting some value from the Flame Waker.
That's good.
Oh, the guys are playing poker behind us. Something just happened on the board. I see Aka Wonder really laughing.
Oh, Mana Worm is pretty good for Eloise next turn. If she doesn't pick up anything else.
Still, Naaman. In an okay spot, you can still tap, I guess. Tap, kill the 2-2, play Gormok. Or even...
Do you? I would go for Rituals. Yeah.
Or now, even consider Councilman, like...
I think you're SSU, you're behind at this point. So you're really looking for the tempo swing with Gormok.
Yeah. Well, are you really behind?
Yeah, this is good as well.
I think I would consider Councilman on turn 7. Because if I go Councilman turn 6, if there's Flame Strike, they can ping it this turn, and then Flame Strike kills it. If I go Councilman on turn 7 myself, they will have to Flame Strike the board and Councilman survive. So this is something about the timing in the matchup that you can consider.
Yeah, that's a very good point. Wow, second Kabbalist Dome. And an Arcane Intellect. So Eloise has a lot of value in her hand, but she just needs to survive. And she's still at 28 HP, so she should be fine.
Should be fine, but there is this ritual, so Councilman is going to connect to face. Flamestrike is not going to kill it, so it's going to have another ritual and connect to face again. What?
The fireball would be so good here. She has three draws for it. If she chooses to go for that.
My goodness. So what do you do? Like, if you Flamestrike, you actually can give your opponent a chance to buff the 7-5 even more.
I think you draw here for a fireball. Or a frostbolt even.
Maybe, can you Kabbal? Not really, because you have only 2 mana left. But if you get like an Ice Lance, there's not that many cards you can play for 2 mana to stop the 7-5.
Yeah, I think I would play the Arcane Intellect.
Yeah, I would go for the Arcane Intellect too.
With Arcane Intellect, you can get Kald Sorceress, for example, and then you'll be able to kill the 7-5 with the Ping and Arcane Blast.
Yep.
She goes for the Toe.
Ooh.
Do you go for Mana Worm, Arcane Missiles now?
I think you have to ping or damage the 7-5, otherwise you're never going to clear it.
Yeah, I agree.
Oh, you like, kind of have Dragon's
next
Breath.
Next turn you can Flame Strike and Missiles too for the 7.
Ooh, Leeroy.
Oh man, but Naaman cannot do much, his board is full. Yeah. So he can tap if he wants to.
This was a pretty smart play by Luis, just not letting him develop anything. Not letting that Councilman get even bigger.
Yeah.
She still have the Ice Block on, so...
Yeah, Iceberg is on. So now you can flame strike this.
Do you flame strike missiles or do you go for mana worm flame strike?
You can mana worm flame strike breath, right? Because breath will be there's 7 minions dying, so breath should be for free.
So you just try to put some pressure onto the warlock's face, or would you breath the 1/1?
I would breath the 1/1, being at 8.
Yeah,
then
probably.
POs buffs.
Does she play 2? Flame strikes or 1?
Not sure.
Because that will make a lot of difference. Because next turn, there will be a ritual again.
Sets them to breath for 0.
Wow, that juggler is really huge. So what Naaman can do here is just put a lot of pressure onto the mage. She has to clear the board and also you're playing ice blockers. Oh, she has an ice block up. Never mind.
Yeah, she has an ice block up. So now the question is, can you pop the ice block? How do you pop the ice block this turn?
I think you tap first.
You...
Because, yeah.
Dark Peddler can help here.
She could have had like a 66% chance, I think. If she played Knife Jiggler. Oh, no.
The one was for board.
Yeah.
Leopard, no!
Ooh, that's actually pretty good.
Leopard Gnome in 2016, what? Eligigo.
We still miss that card as a 2-1.
Yeah. Maybe it'll come back someday. Maybe after the next rotation, the card pool will be so small, Leopard Gnome will be actually good.
I would have played the Knife Juggler there, I think, and just play 3 rituals. Get the 3 juggles.
Naaman is testing for a possible AoE again.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, but...
How can he pop the block, though? Can he pop the block next turn? I guess like he will try at least with the juggler.
Yeah, but she got extra time right now. It's like...
Yeah, I think he had to go for the juggler last turn.
Does she play Yogg?
Yes, I believe she does.
Okay.
I'm not sure, though, but I think
probably.
In this kind of deck you should play Yogg.
Yeah, okay. Arcane Intellect into Yogg.
The problem that Eloise is facing right now is not only the board that she has to kill and protect herself, but also she doesn't really have a clear strategy how to win this game. I mean, she has a clear strategy with the deck, but she doesn't have enough damage in hand to be able to go for face. Because she has an iceberg, if she would be able to go for face with all this, like how much damage there is? There's Arcane Missiles with the board, doesn't deal that much. There is
the
Yogg.
There's the Yogg.
Wow.
Yeah, I guess the Yogg is something. How much damage can she really deal this turn?
Because she's going face.
Yeah.
With the Dragon's Breath, yeah.
Yeah, she still has the Dragon's Breath.
Is Fireball next turn actually lethal? Yeah, I think it is.
Yeah.
All right. Dragon's Breath is dealing how much damage? 4, right? Yeah. So we have... And Dragon Breath can actually go face. So it's 5 damage from that. She still has a good chance. She has an Iceberg on.
So,
all she needs is a Fireball ball.
Wait, can he actually pop the block and clear the board?
Yeah, he can with Gormok.
Yeah, but no, he can't really do both things at the same time. So he's missing one.
No, he actually can.
He can with the juggle as well.
If Yogg kills the Leopard Gnome,
No, it's only 2 damage. She's at 3.
Yeah, he's popping a 3. Okay.
Yeah, but Fireball wins this.
Yeah.
We've seen double Frostbolt, right? What else was this? Does this card win the game? It actually can.
So you Azure Drake tried to fish for a Fireball. If it doesn't happen, you can play missiles plus Dragon Breath.
Yeah, but then
try to get lucky.
2 missiles have to go phase then, right?
Yeah.
If Brad is like 5.
Yeah, but you can ping, right? If it kills minions. I'm not sure.
I guess Yogg is the only chance. You did cast those spells. Okay. It's Yogg's round time. Raise Yogg! Eloise goes for only wood condition here.
A secret? What secret was it?
We don't know.
A vaporize, I see here.
You can actually use your mouse and see the secret exactly.
So Ice Block and Vaporize. Okay.
Ice Block and Vaporize. That's pretty good.
But Ice Block doesn't work if she kills herself now, because it only works on the opponent's
turn. She will not
kill.
Yeah, definitely. And Leprinum dies, right?
Oh, and Yorck survives, and Yorck.
What? Oh. She discards her hand?
Oh no.
Wow. So intense.
There is a flare.
Charge? I saw her point something.
Conceal.
And there is a fireball in hand.
Oh, wow.
Fireball in hand is still lethal next turn. She still has nice block. She survived.
And there's actually no way for Naaman to win.
Yes!
Wow.
Eloise will take this match. There's nothing Naaman can do.
Is own York? No.
No, he doesn't play York. So.
I guess he's thinking at this point, if there's an ice barrier, he still doesn't have enough damage. No, there is. So he needs to tap.
What secret can it be that he just wins? Like Mirror Entity? Spellbender?
Yeah.
Well, he just has to take this chance. This can be a counter spell and Spellbender.
I think he has to tap, right? For if it's a barrier.
And that's unfortunately Vaporize. Well played, there's still an ice block.
Oh, that's incredible. A bit of VM from
Yorck winning games
Eloise.
Again.
That was crazy, and Eloise advances to tomorrow. Where Naaman will have to face either Frodon or Ekop. Team Horus wins 200 points, guys.
And the Bible Tomb face is gone right now.
Yeah, she's definitely happy. Temple Storm advancing to the top eight. So let's make some space for Eloise. No, just stay. Stay beside. It's good. All right, just stay with us. We planned for this, Midside. We planned for this. So, Eloise. Eloise, put your mic closer to your mouth if you can.
Huh?
Your mic closer to your mouth. The mic is, you have the mic here. Okay, perfect.
Hello?
Hey, welcome.
Hey.
Hi.
Praise Yogg-Saron.
I mean, that was like a 15 spell Yogg-Saron, so it has to be good.
It has to be good, right? Yeah. And it was good. So, when you lost with your warrior, to Zhu, were you afraid that you're going to lose the whole match? Because Temple Mage versus Zul, it's not that favored.
My Temple Mage is a hard counter Zul, you know?
Really? It's good? It's good? Are you serious?
Well, do I look not serious? I'm always serious.
Okay, you are a serious person. But it worked really well. It worked really well, especially a Kabali Stone to Kabali Stone. You were fighting hard and that Yorck-Saron.
I messed up a little bit, but... So sad I didn't swipe him with my warrior. Feels bad, man.
That was a big chance, actually, to do, like, to swipe him with the warrior. He was... Do you think he should actually ban your warrior?
Yeah, like, I play this exactly lineup as him. I don't know why he doesn't ban my warrior, but you know, his deck is slightly different from me, like...
Yeah.
It seems like his deck is built for like banning Zhu. Like for example, he has Leroy in his Zhu, he has Antonitus in his Temple Mage.
Yeah.
So it's like super unfavored against Zhu. So it seems reasonable he banned my Zhu, but I still think that banning Warrior might be better.
Well, he was really close to winning versus you as well. So.
Because it is very easy for Temple Mage and Zhu to like tech against a mirror, but it is very hard for those kind of class to tech against a warrior. You know?
All right, makes sense. And now you advance to the top eight, so only like, are you going to cheer for Frodon? He still has to win
this Zeke. Yeah, of course. He landed me his luck. I'm going to land him my RNG too. My Yogg-Saron.
All right, so if Frodon has your Yogg-Saron RNG, he should be able to do it.
Yes,
so
he should be able to do it.
Mitsuhai Chinos, do you have any questions for Eloise?
Not really.
What was your idea when you saw the Astral Communion from Yorck?
You know, I had like around 10 cards left, so it is the time to draw a fireball. So like when I see the Astral Communion, I know that I'm going to draw a card, so I'm not that sad, you know?
Yeah.
That's a good explanation.
And, you know, I already have my ice block and the Vaporize, so I'm not scared of everything.
Exactly.
Whatever!
nothing can kill you, so it's 5. Exactly, so that was a really good ending. All right, Eloise comes forward to the next day, and we'll still have a lot of matches for you. We have Frodon versus Ekop, we have the winner of that versus Naaman, And obviously on the secondary stream, we have also great matches. So tune in for more Hearthstone. We'll be